Property development has been the main business of Geovalley Sindhi & Berhad since its inception in 1996. The company started on a modest scale, but has since expanded significantly to become an integrated company with building construction and civil structural consultancy services under the group operation. The company is a member of Lone Pine Group of Companies. Our current major development projects are located strategically in Pyatiraban, or thriving suburb of Penang, where the group is already well established. We will continue in its quest and long-term objective to build sustainable township and better community.
I am Kaliyama, anak perempuan Tengah Jabani. I was a nurse in the community. Yes, during my nursing time, that's how I met these children in this rural area where children were abandoned. They didn't get their basic in life, a proper home, proper food, care and love, and no education. I saw them just roaming about and all this. So I started helping them during those days when I was a nurse. And then I came to know there are many children with no birth certificates, and they were staying in containers, pigsties, and all this. So as a nurse, I did all my best with the kampung people here. So one day I realized that I'll be going on retirement, and I have to leave this place to go back to my hometown. So I just don't want to leave them just like that. So I thought of taking an optional retirement early, so that to do something for them, to feel something. I came to this area in 1991. That time I was a nurse in Permakang Damalau, a community nurse. And then I took option 1998, option retirement. Because my retirement was in 2000. So I didn't want to wait till retire, because maybe I'm old or maybe I'm not fit to do it. So when I'm healthy, I want to do something for these children, to start off something so that somebody will continue this mission and vision.
Do you know? They still struggle for a permanent home to help the unfortunate.
Before the turn of the millennium, a community exists in the township of Permakang Damalau Wood. Within the community, poverty reigns. The unfortunate lived from hand to mouth. Alcoholism, drug abuse, wife battery and abandoned children were commonplace. There were children born without birth certificates. Many of them did not go to school. Families lived in squalor and poverty. Some of them live in a makeshift huts behind pallet factories or in disused pigsty and containers.
So I think these two hands is not enough to do this work, and one head is not enough also. So that's how I met my friend Linda Gregory. She's a social worker. She has the same feeling for the poor, and so we joined up. Both of us have the same interest to do something for the needy ones. So we started looking for a home so that we can rent and start off. And when we were looking for a home, we got a home in Permakang Damalau, that is 7137 Permakang Damalau. We saw the rental board outside, it's for rent. So we immediately called the owner, and so he also very pleased to give his home for a charity purpose. So we started a rent of about $800, I think. And he opened up two doors for us, and he kept one. Actually, this building having three houses in one. But at the beginning, he just gave us two. And he kept one for himself. And later part, after 2 years, he opened up the three doors for us to do this charitable work. So we started with 18 children. Actually, we wanted to do a daycare. We wanted to take the children from this area, send them to school, take care of them, give them food, the necessary, and then send them back home. But later, children often started coming in from other states, from Seberang Jaya, Juru, from Negeri Sembilan and all this. So our home became full time. So I have to stay in here full time, and Linda comes here morning 9 till 5, 6 she'll be with me. So she does all the outside work and I do all the inside. So I serve and she do all the paperwork and all that, like going to bank, going to welfare office, and we started getting birth certs and all this for the children, and started sending the children to school.
Abandoned children and orphans are brought up with an education, and in an atmosphere of warmth and loving kindness provided by Ms. Carly, Ms. Linda, and the volunteers. A beacon of light shines in the dark shroud of despair.
When I and Linda started this home, so we first made ourselves very clear that this is God's work. God has given us this opportunity to serve the poor. So we are not going to take anything from the poor. In fact, we wanted to give them. And we want God to provide us everything. So we have very good faith in it. So this is God's work, and God will provide us all our needs. And all these 10 years it has been going on like that, because we don't go for publicity and we don't go out for donations. We are not government aided and no politics involved. So our home is fully God aided. All our children are given free care. Food is supplied to them. We send them to school. Bus fees is being paid. Books have been bought for them. Clothing. And during our festivals, they will be given new clothes. They have been sent to tuitions. So they get what a normal child should get. What my child get, the same thing. They get what I and Linda do for our children. We do the same for these children. We accept them as our children. And here there is no age limited, because we take in children from birth. Because what I came to know, like other places, there's some age limit. They don't want a little children. So we thought, if nobody wants them, where will this child go? We don't want them to go to the dustbin, to the rivers. So we said, we decided to take care of them. We will pay somebody a little bit and we'll take care of these little ones from birth. And we have taken care already about 3 little kids from birth, from 1 week, from 1 month, 2 months old, and now they are 3-4 years. As a nurse, I was very close and I had the opportunity to touch, go very near to them as a community nurse. Because I can visit a home till their bedroom, till their kitchen and all that. You see, so I was working very close and I made myself go down to their levels. So I come to find out what is their problems. And they don't mind sharing with me. So because they accepted me.
So
the community.
You find that in our society, so some people are actually up to this level.
Yes.
Have to live in a container.
Yes. And I was very shocked. It happened in Penang. You see, there are people who are staying in containers, in pigsties, in couches, and all this. So what we did, we wanted to give a better life. We wanted to have the basic in life. So we transfer them to flats. So we pay their first deposit. It comes to about 200, and here another 500, 700, and sometimes we have to pay even the broker's fees to get us a flat. So it comes about $800 to $900 to get a flat for them. And we work very close with the church, with Baba centers, with Buddhist centers, with other NGOs to make this program a successful one. And we want others to share and get God's grace too, not only we too. We give opportunity to others to join us to help the needy ones, and they helped us a lot, like church, Vincent de Paul, other churches, Buddhist centers, Baba centers, other NGOs. Hold hands, we hold hands with them to help the needy ones. because I come straight contact with them. Others might not know there are cases in Penang like this.